first slide.
Hello. For those who doesn't know us, next to me is Zuzana Bodnárová, art historian, culture manager. I am Svetopluk Mikita, visual artist, leader of contemporary drawing and printmaking studio in Brno. For this presentation, we choose position of creative director and executive director.
And president.
Sorry, we are coming from countryside. Sorry for our village English.
But I think that we know each other. We visited first time Český Těšín and Polský Těšín 5 years ago, so we know the Šára, Lukáš, Aša, and we have here good friends Karolina and Tomáš. They usually host us as squatters in their own flat. This first slide, I cannot see it, it looks like... first slide, it's a very bucolic, romantic. We were in this moment much more younger. It's 11 years ago, and we freshly bought a small mining house in a village called Ilia. Ilia is the name of the village.
In 2004, we became to be citizens of this village with the number 332 and 333.
Yes, so we can go and vote our local mayor, so we have this kind of power in our hands. And close to this village is another village. It's more city with under 10,000 citizens. It's Banská Štiavnica. Šemnitz Báňa for our Hungarian friends, and it's it was mining very rich city. It was I think second very important city in the Middle Age with all this gold and silver production. Now it's more than touristic attraction. It's quite the historical city center is empty. But just for your information, this is the map of Slovakia. Probably you know where Slovakia is. And in the middle of nowhere, it's Banská Štiavnica. We are very close to Hungarian border.
We try to make profit from this position. We are very close to Budapest. It's even closer, like to our capital, Bratislava.
But we don't have a car yet, so if you are taking the train or bus, it took 6 hours to go to Budapest by car. It's 2 hours. Yeah, this is the historical city center. Banská Štiavnica is on the list of this UNESCO heritage. Yes. So it looks like Christmas tree is very nice and romantic with genius loci and historical background with many historical buildings.
But we are our project not in the historical city center. We are three kilometers far on the periphery.
Yes, so this is our area. There is no any historical building around. There is only station, and the kind of history of our civic association started that was 7 years ago. We got an idea. We were still living in Prague, where I was working, and Svetopluk came times from Bratislava to visit me, and you know, and. in this time we got the idea that okay, we were quite tired, and we said okay, now let's move to the bigger city, or let's go move to the countryside. So we said no, bigger city, let's move
countryside and relax a little bit. But now, so let's say now we are relaxing in this huge building, which was built in end of 40s. It's a very nice architecture structure with the green surrounding around.
And important thing is that it's a station, still function railway station. quite big, as you see from outside.
We can see the train also.
Yes, the maybe the funny, but for us not funny, but serious things is that from 2011 we are selling also the ticket. So if you come to visit us and you would like to buy the ticket, so Svetopluk Mikita or me, I will sit there and I can inform you what kind of connection you have to Bratislava, to Budapest.
And we have money from selling the tickets, but we don't have so many travelers, so the week is not so big.
Yeah, so we need travelers, please. Yeah? Because we have some person from each ticket.
And the project we're under, it's a kind of a sanatorium for artists. They can stay there and work in a quite healthy area.
Yes, that was the statement from artists, from organizer. We are running their artists in residency, so we are waiting for kind of resultat after the residency. So not only the relaxing and drinking the good local wine. You can see surrounding of the station, it's really very ugly, and maybe probably that was the reason that it's not attractive for business.
Local business,
yes. Maybe as a storage, but nobody wants to use a station as a storage.
So, as Zuzana mentioned, we run a primary artist in residence program there, and we have a different kind of residencies.
From micro residencies, so artists can stay 1 to 3 weeks, till long-term residency. We have really nice cooperation with the International Visegrad Fund. They have supported our residency from the really beginning. So each year we have minimum one Visegrad residence. Then we have special formats of residency, like you can see on the photos. It's the photos from a residency format called acclimatization. It's focus or it's it, we try to support fresh graduated artists. Probably some of you finished the art school, and immediately after your final exam, you start to think how to deal with the reality. So we offer like 1 month acclimatization after the school and before the real life. So,
each year we choose one artist, and 2012 we choose Juraj Gábor. He came for 1 month, but after this 1 month he decided to stay and to he become to be colleague of us for next 1.5 year.
Yeah, so that's also image from the area. Yeah, let's go inside the station, the most important place and most visually attractive. It's the waiting hall. It's quite huge. It's more than 200 square meter, and the highest is approximately 10. It's kind of a church, and it's empty. Of course, during the socialism, when the people used the train each hour, the hall was full of passengers. Now we have 20 people during 1 day, so it's nothing. And this place we use as a kind of exhibition place, but we are not curator, we are not doing exhibition as regular exhibition. So that's Tomáš Žadoň piece.
Which become to be famous in the
yes.
City. So this is not installed photo, so it's really...
Oh. Yeah, we don't know these people. This is the same place, so you can see how we use the public place. Let's say internal information is that we are not paying for renting of this place. We use it as a as a squatters, let's say, but for the rest of the of the square meters of the rooms, we should pay. We should pay electricity. We should pay heating and renting. It's approximately 3,000 something euro per year.
Yeah. Yes, the building structure is quite huge. So some space we are renting, and some of them we use
just occupy. Now you can see nice contact with the reality, with travelers.
In summer we have more travelers because tourists are coming to the city.
I think it's Paula Dvornik from 2009, our first resident. This is also archive photos. It's from the beginning, our atelier. No, and this is the condition, how it's look after 3 years. It's, by the way, it's Adam Kokesh atelier. Handa Gotte was there also.
Three months residency.
Yes, this is Peter Pukluš atelier. Peter Pukluš working some, no, yeah, we just choose these photos as a proof that really artists should do some project. And then we are waiting for some results. Yeah, this is last year. Also nice cooperation with the Visegrad Foundation.
Habina Fuchs doesn't like to work inside. She doesn't like the rooms there, so she asked to have more contact with nature. So we built this kind of studio outside for her.
Yes, open air studio, and on the end of the residency, we use the wood from the studio to make the big fire and to burn the ceramic object. The results or the art pieces from the residency were presented in Sweet Gallery in November last year. Yeah, for our Polish colleague, we also like to invite Polish artist without any support from the Visegrad. So the first photos, just go back, Svetio. It's Agnieszka Grodzinska. She was our resident last summer, and now we are preparing kind of two artistic book with her Xero copy project. And year before, two guys same t-shirts, let's say. The right side is Jakub Čišťan from Poland. We have nice contact with the Poland Poznań group. And the left side is Honza Zalešák, curator from Czech Republic. So we tried also somehow inspire real curator to visit our place and to talk with the artists.
Because in the historical city center there are no curators?
There are no curators in Banská Štiavica, no art scene, no communities. So you already saw our, let's say, public spaces,
working area,
and the artist can also stay in our
industrial rooms.
Yes.
Only basic construction.
So we are not we don't have the ambition to change station into the white cube gallery. So we don't have professional lights for working, and there is no, for example, water in atelier. So these kind of things. But from the beginning, when we started, we would like to have some project, to have some contact with the artist. Now we have the kind of history, so probably it's time to move somewhere.
The other residency project is 6x9 meter residency. We invite each year artists for this, and it's connected with the main wall in the waiting hall, because the local people, even after 3 years, doesn't recognize we are there, so now we are showing art pieces in the main hall.
Yeah, this is the fresh new result of residency which Svetopluk mentioned, graphic studio The Rodina. Probably some of you know the couple Vid Ruler and Teresa Rulerova. They are graphic designers and they did for waiting hall these digital paintings.
Year before it was too pessimistic, so the next year we make kind of optimistic art.
And this kind of art pieces, the residency is during the summertime and whole winter and spring next year it's installed in the hall, so everybody coming to station, travelers, visitors can say something how they feel the art piece, and that was the most important reaction, that it's better this year because it's optimistic. We are also doing not only visual residency, but we try during the summertime especially make some concert, debate, workshop. You can see concert in the industrial area because there is many empty bankrupt building from socialism and so on. And we have also export residency. Yeah, we have also traveling residency and other formats, but probably we can speak later in some debate or informal atmosphere. But we have two export residencies. We try to export Slovak artists to abroad.
In 2013 we established an exchange with a residency in Bern in Swiss. On the top of the roof you can see Slovakian artists.
Yeah, there. It's Martin Kochan. Martin Kochan was there 2 years ago. Last year it Peter Bareni and Mira Gaberová. And the next export residency it's in New York. We established it last year together with our let's say private partner in Brooklyn, and first resident was Katarina Hrušková. Now we are finishing how to say it, Platnia? Vinyl. Vinyl.
Produce vinyl. Yeah. Output of our project.
Publication. We yesterday we came by train, so we just took
we
some.
We don't have everything with us, but we have some of the publications, so
you can
see it later.
You can watch it and what kind of books. There is no any big theoretical books. It's most of them are outputs from the residencies with a kind of intro or essay with some essay of curators which we invite to the project. We are selling the books and according the money, I don't know if we would like to say something like practically, but for example, from the Ministry of Culture, Rado already mentioned this strange position. We have the end of the March and we till this moment we don't know if we will get the money for this year program. So each winter, and we survive 7 winter in region already, so each winter I would like to move from the region because there is like depression. You cannot plan, or you can plan, you can euphorize people and artists, but on the end, if you will not get the money, you should improvise. And so now we are waiting, so all Slovak culture scene waiting for result of the grants. Last year we got 20,000 euro, so we paid everything. 20,000 is like nothing. residency, publication, graphic designers. We try to like, this was our like first discussion that each artist should be paid, each graphic designer should be paid, so we don't have this kind of voluntary work. Only Svetopluk and me, we are working for free. And yeah, that was the connection with the books. So also small profit from the books, from the art pieces, which we are also selling, can
help us finance our activities. And we also have some plans. On this photo you can see a building which is connected with the station. It's also it's a railway property, and already for a few months will be closely 1 year. We are fighting because we like to buy this storage which is abandoned, and it's our plan to
This is our plan, but the deal with the state and the railway is like long term project. So
now we are waiting for election next year.
Yes. Thank you.